Can you see the screen? Is it visible to you? Okay, thank you, thank you. So yesterday's class, we were discussing about certain sentences that we can use when we write formal letters, as well as we can the sentences that we can write when we are writing a report, a technical report, the starting part, the introduction part, then how we can express our opinion, then giving examples, comparing, and conclusion. Okay, so with this we ended yesterday. The last topic was how to write a conclusion. How will we start a sentence in order to write a conclusion? So these sentences, if you learn, there are numerous sentences, and even you can create your own sentences. But if you don't know how to write a sentence, just by heart some of the sentences that seems to be attractive to you, and then if you use it in writing, then your writing will improve a lot. Okay, that is how we usually improve our writing skills. After we imitate others, then we try to do it ourselves. Okay. Is it clear? Hope I'm audible to you. Okay. Okay, thank you. So next we are going to sequence words. What are sequence words? You might have used it when you might have read about it. You will be frequently using it in sentences, or when you read storybooks and all, you come across all these sentences. But these words that help us to understand a sequence in which certain events are happening is called a sequence word. And for example, if I want to introduce something, I can use the term first of all. Okay, first of all, I would like to. Is it clear? 1 minute, please. I can open till. Okay, so that I can mark this sentence. I'm opening it in PDF. So, sequence words, they help us to understand the order in which something is happening. That is, if I want to introduce something, I can write, first of all, I would like to introduce something. So, the word first is a sequence word. It helps us to order sentences one by one. So these words, they help us to understand the order of events that are happening in a story, or the order of events that are happening in a speech, etc. And they identify things like what comes first, what comes next, what had happened earlier, or etc. The sequence in which events had occurred can be easily presented using sequence words. Okay. And these are the some of the examples. There are a lot of examples. Like you can start with first of all, or we can say in the beginning. That means something that happened initially. And after that news, which means after a news has come out, something happened after the news. So it is helping us to understand the time period in which, or the order in which certain events had occurred. And see, most of the stories which you read in your childhood days, it starts with once upon a time. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful princess. These are beautiful stories and which help us to understand a time period during which this story is happening. Okay, so this is the common word which as children know from their childhood days. That is once upon a time. Every story in a kid's story, they begin with these sentences that attract students towards the children towards the story. So, and it also helps us to understand a time period. So these are all sequence words which help us to understand when a particular event had occurred. Then another word, another sentence is in the end. That is what happened at last. We want to say what is the last event that had occurred. Then we say in the end. So these words or these sentences, they help us to identify the sequence of events happening in a story or in a speech or in a whatever writing you have. It helps us to understand the sequence. So another thing is all of a sudden means what is the time at which this event is happening? All of a sudden, I heard a loud noise, a loud sound. This all of a sudden, it tells us that something is happening right now at the present. Okay, so these are the time at which it helps us to identify the time at which certain events occur. And these are a few examples of sequence words that can be used in sentences. Okay, is it clear to you? Is it clear to you? Hello? Okay. So what are sequence sentences? What are sequence sentences? What are sequence sentences? Just in a few words, can anyone say what are sequence sentences? See, where are the rest? Only 56, excluding me, there will be only 54 students here now. What happened to the others? Was the attendance like this before? The previous hour? Hello? So I'll be taking attendance in between, okay? So, what are sequence words? Nobody knows the answer? Okay, I'll repeat once more. So, sequence words are those words which help us to understand the order in which certain events are happening. Okay, while we are writing a story, reading a story, or while we are writing an essay, it helps us to order the sentences or arrange sentences in a particular order. And so it helps us to understand the sequence or the order in which certain events are happening. And these are the examples that is we use first of all in a sentence to indicate that an event is happening first, the event that has happened first. And in the beginning also it will help us to understand that something that had happened earlier. And then after the news, that means something happened after a news had come out. Then, once upon a time, it is again showing a time period long back. And to show the end, we use in the end. And to show the present situation or the surprising situation or a sudden outbreak, we call it as all of a sudden. We can use these sentences. So these are the words which help us to order other sentences in our writings. So these are called sequence words. Okay. Hello, is it okay now? Like we'll say, when we start a speech, we say, first and foremost, I would like to welcome. And then we say, next, I would like to welcome. So these sentences, these words which help us to order sentences, they are called sequence words. Then, now, that is all about sequence words. That is, words help us to arrange sentences. Those words which help us to arrange sentences. Now we are going to the next section, misspelled words. Misspelled words means words that are frequently written wrongly. Most of us make mistakes while writing spellings. So there are certain words which are always written, and most of us, a majority of the people, write wrongly and that incorrectly. And so these incorrect words, these words which are often written incorrectly, are called misspelled words. Now let us see some of the misspelled words. And here we can have arranged it in the order from letter A to Z. Commonly misspelled words from the starting with letter A and then B and so on. Here, what you have to do is you have to learn these sentences, learn these words, just like synonyms. I had given you synonyms starting with A. and all other synonyms, that is from letter B to Z, I had uploaded it in Linways. So you have to study at least 5 words a day from those list. And finally, there will be a test for synonyms. There will be a test for misspelled words, etc. So instead of telling you to study everything together, I am giving you an information that you will study earlier itself, that there will be a test and you have to study at least 5 words in a day, so that it doesn't become a tedious task for you at the end. Okay, and knowing the spelling, how to write words, is very important, not only in English, but even when you write your other core papers also, you have to write correctly without any spelling mistake. So just go through. And an easy way to study these spellings and synonyms is you first identify or strike out those words which you know well. Okay, when you go through these lists, you just strike out those words which you know correctly, and then you identify those which you doesn't know, and learn those words. Once you learn those words, again you can strike it off, and finally check whether you do a test, or you can write it by yourself and see if you are writing it correctly. Okay, see, now with letter A, there is a word a lot of people. Sometimes people misunderstand, they write it together, a lot, but it is two words, a and lot. Then a while is again two separate words. Then absence, these are the common words which we make mistake. Accept, ACC, there are two C's, acceptable, accessible, across. See, sometimes people misunderstand, they write ACCROSS. It's only, it's repeated here, so just take it once. ACROSS. Then achieve, accommodate. Accommodate has two C and two M. People are all often confused whether there is one C or two M, or two M or one C, etc. And accidentally has two C. ACC. Accompanied, ACC. Okay, so these are the mistakes that we make, whether we have to write one letter or whether there are two letters, etc. And just go through it and study the words. Most of you might know all these words, but if you don't know any of these words, just study it, okay? Just read it casually, and when you know, if you doesn't know any words, just try to learn it. Okay. Is it clear to you? This is just to improve your language skill, okay? Can you hear me? Hello, can you hear me? Okay. So, see, improving your language, it is very important. Not only here, but throughout your life, wherever you go, you need to communicate in English. If you're working in good companies, and you have to build up your language base thoroughly, okay? So whenever you get time, just go through these words, learn these words. Don't try to learn it all together. If you're trying to learn it all together, it will be confusing. So just learn a few words a day. So I have written letters with B also. And basically, these are simple words which you know. Another word which we often make mistake is business. B-U-S-I-N-E-S-S. Sometimes we write B-U-S-S-I. It is B-U-S-I-N-E-S-S, business, barbecue, okay. So, calendar, C-A-L-E-N-D-A-R, calendar, camouflage, C-A-M-O-U-F-L-A-G-E, camouflage, okay. And these are the, okay, colleague, C-O-L-L-E-A-G-U-E, colleague, colosseum. And coolie, C-O-O-L-L-Y, coolie. Okay, some of the words which often we make mistakes. And so on. And so these are the words which you should exercise. You come across this every day in your daily life, exercise. Then Then another word which I would like to train, gauge, G-A-U-G-E, gauge. 40, when you write the learn, write the number 40. It's not F-O-U-R-T-Y, it is F-O-R-T-Y, 40. Fluorescent, F-L-U-O, fluorescent, fluorescent, F-L-U-O-R-E-S-C-E-N-T, fluorescent. Likewise, Fahrenheit, the temperature measurement in Fahrenheit, F-A-H-R-E-N-H-E-I-T, Fahrenheit. Just study the spelling, this is important, Fahrenheit, F-A-H-R-E-N-H-E-I-T is Fahrenheit. And there are these such technical terms you should know very well, okay? And the spelling of grammar, G-R-A-M-M-A-R, grammar. So, another word is there, vacuum. Can you spell the word vacuum? Anyone? Can you spell the word vacuum? Can anyone type in the chat box, vacuum? Have you heard of vacuum? Vacuum, empty space. Yes, correct. V-A, Gobiga had written correctly. V-A-C-U-U-M, vacuum. Malavika has written correctly. Ashwin also has written correctly. Okay, V-A-C-U-U-M, vacuum. I don't know. Are you searching for the word and then typing it? Hello, did you know the word? Did you know the spelling before? Hello. Okay, very good, very good. Happy to see the correct answer. So such words you should learn well, okay? Without mistake, it will build up your language base. Wherever you go, you can speak confidently if you know the language well. Now, okay, so we have to, I'll be informing you earlier when the test will be conducted. It may be like a quiz. I will be publishing a quiz in LingWays, like to choose the correct spelling and all, or to say, choose the meaning in the case of synonyms, and you have to do the test and submit. Okay, I will be announcing the test later. And anyway, I'm giving you 2 weeks' time to study the spelling. Only a few words are written here. So just go through it, study the spelling when you get, don't try to study it in a single stretch. Study few words daily. And after 2 or 3 weeks, I will be conducting a test, a small test as quiz. Okay. So you should improve your spelling skills also. Now we are going to compound words. What are compound words? Have you heard of compound words? Simple words and compound words. What are simple words? What are compound words? What are simple words and what are compound words? Can you say what is a simple word? A simple word is a word which cannot be broken down into smaller words. Simple word. Now also, what is a compound word? A simple word is a word which cannot be broken down into smaller words. Like was, W-A, it has a subword, but you don't get any meaningful subwords when you are breaking that word. Okay, so simple words, when we break a simple word, we don't get meaningful subwords. And such words are called simple words. Now, what are compound words? What are compound words? Very easy, isn't it? Words which can be broken down into smaller words that are meaningful are called compound words. A single word which can be broken down into smaller words, and each small word that we had got is meaningful. So that is called compound words. Now let us go through these compound words. So these words are formed when two or more words put together to form a new word with a new meaning. Okay, I said of breaking the sentences, but the definition says you're joining the sentence. Just the opposite. The definition is going the opposite way to what I had said. That is, the words are formed when two or more words are put together to form a new word with a new meaning. So when two or more words are combined together to form a new word is called, it forms a compound word. Is it clear? Is it clear to you? Did you understand what are compound words? Okay. When two or more words, when they are combined together, they form a new word with a new meaning. They will have a, that combined word will have a new meaning when compared to the small words that we have joined. It will give another meaning to that. The compound word will have another meaning, a new meaning. Such words are called compound words. See, I had given two examples here. Sunflower. What are the two words formed from this? Which all words join to form sunflower? Which all small words, simpler words join to form sunflower? Sunflower is a compound word. Okay, sun and flower. Sun has a meaning. You know what sun is. And flower also has a meaning. But we combine it together, it forms another word with a new meaning. It is the name of a flower. It is not the name of sun or anything else. It forms another meaning. It gives a new meaning. The compound word has a new meaning. For another example, moonlight. Moonlight. The compound words formed are, this compound word is formed from which all words? Moon and light. Very simple, isn't it? So moon and light, they have different meaning. Moon is one word, light is another word. But when we combine together, we get a word called moonlight, which has entirely different meaning than the original words. So such words are called compound words. Okay, now we can classify these compound words, types of compound words. What are the different types of compound words? There are three types of compound words. Compound words are of three types. There are three types of compound words. First one is the closed compound word. Second one is the open compound word. And the last one is hyphenated compound word. So these are the three types of compound words. We said that compound words are formed from simple words. When two or more words put together, two or more words, it can be, there can be three words also. So when two or more words put together, and there can be even more. That's why I just said the definition says two or more words. So when two or more words put together, they form compound words. And there are three types of compound words. First is closed compound word. Second is open compound word. And the third one is hyphenated compound words. So three types of compound words. Now let us see what are these things. Closed compound words. What are closed compound words? See, these words, they are formed when two unique words are joined together. The definition itself says this only. That is, they are formed when two unique words. Just know this, when two unique words are joined together, and when we write it as a compound word, they do not have space in between. When we write this word, they will not have space in between. Okay, so when two words are joined together and when we write the joined word or the compound word without any space in between, we call it as closed compound words. For example, the first one, cannot. What are the two words formed from cannot? What are the two words formed from cannot? What are the two words? Split the word, you get the subwords. What are the two words formed? Can and not. So when we join it together, we write it as cannot. So do we put space in between when we write the single word cannot? When we write the word C-A-N-N-O-T, do we put space in between? No. If there are no space in between when we join two words, then such words are called closed compound words. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear to you? Did you understand what closed compound words are? Okay, Ashwin. So, another word, together. How will you split this word, together? What are the subwords in that compound word? It is a closed compound word. See, we have, there is no space in between words. So it is a closed compound word. What are the subwords that we get from the word together? Anyone? Fast. Come on. No, the spelling is together, T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R. You are changing the spelling. Together. There is a word called gather. There is no gather. No, where is G? You are missing G, gather. There should be all letters in that word. To get her. Yes, Fatima. Your name is Shahala. To get her. Yes. There are three words in it. But all spelling is there, correctly spelled, but no space in between. So it is to get her together. Okay. So another word, baseball. Base is one word, ball is another word. But when we write it as, when we combine it together, there is no space in between. So it is called, so this is a closed compound word. Okay. Is it clear? So likewise, you have fireworks. There are interesting words. Fireworks, crosswalk, grandmother. Grand is one word. Mother is another word. But together it forms a new word with a new meaning. Then elsewhere. Else is one word. Where is another word. Basketball, sunflower, as we said earlier. Then become. Be and come. Be is another word. One word and come is another word. Moonlight, weatherman, grasshopper. Grass is one word, hopper is another word. Football, everything. Every is one word and thing is another word. But when we write it together, we don't put space in between. We write it as a single word. Likewise, earthquake. It is also written as a single word. Anybody. Schoolhouse, sometimes. Stake, a skateboard. Fireflies, upstream, up and stream. Inside, in and side. They are two different words. In is one word, side is another word, but written as a single word, inside. Railroad, playthings. Okay, so I have written a sentence, an example here. The fireflies buzzed in the night sky. So it is an example of how this compound word is used in a sentence. Fireflies. It is a compound word, but when combined together, fire is one word, flies is another word, but combined together to form a single word without space in between. So it is a closed compound word. Okay. Is it clear to you? Closed compound words? Okay. Okay, very good. So now let us go to the second type of compound words, and that is open compound words. This is just the opposite of closed. Open compound words, they have space in between. We write it as a combination of words, but they have space in between and the between the words. But when read together, we read it as a single word. It has a single meaning also. A single meaning is formed. A new meaning is formed. We read it as a single word, but it has space in between. But when the words are combined, it has again a new meaning. The difference is that there is space in between these words in open compound words. There is no space in closed compound words. So let us see. Look at this example. Ice cream. It is a combination of two words, but often when we combine them, we usually put space in between. You don't exclude that space. You have to put space in between when you write ice cream. It is not a single word. It is an open compound word. Real estate. Again, it is a combination of two words, but there is space in between. Full moon. We don't write it together as full moon. Half sister. Post office. We don't usually avoid the space. It is written as two words only. Grand jury, middle class, attorney general. Attorney general. They are two words, but combined together to give a designation. An example sentence is written here. Ice cream is my favorite dessert. Okay. To just make a sentence with a compound word. Ice cream is a open compound word. And I had just written an example sentence using this open compound word. Okay. So open compound words have space in between. They are formed from two or more words. When combined together, they give a new meaning. But the thing is, there is space in between the words. Is it clear? Hello, is it clear to you? Okay. Okay. So, next, the third type of word is hyphenated compound words. We put a hyphen in between the words. Therefore, these compound words are formed from two or more words, but we put a hyphen in between these words and they are read together also. Then we get a new meaning from these words. And let us see what these hyphenated words are. They are connected by hyphen. Hyphen is a dash, isn't it? And this hyphenated compound words, they come as, they are also, certain words are known as modifying compound words. And these modifying compound words are hyphenated when they precede a noun, and they are not hyphenated when they come after a noun. I'll tell you what it is. Let us see the examples first. See, look at the examples, hyphenated compound words. When I write one half, it is one hyphen half. 86, when you write the word, write in word, 86. 80 hyphen 6. Normally, we don't use this, but when you're referring to a single number, we write it as 86. Then, merry-go-round. Merry-go-round, we read it as a single word. Merry is one word, go is another word, round is again another word. All of them have different meaning, but when put together, it has a new meaning, merry-go-round. Mother-in-law is again hyphenated word. One third of the earth is land. When we write one third, then well-being, mass-produced, over-the-counter, daughter-in-law. These are the words that use hyphens in between. And a sentence is, my mother-in-law is coming for a visit. A hyphenated mother-in-law is a hyphenated compound word. So I've just used it in a sentence to show how you should use it. That is, you should put hyphen in between when you write mother-in-law, father-in-law, daughter-in-law, sister-in-law, etc. Anyway, there are three words combined together. Now let us see another type of compound word called the modifying compound words. See, look at this example. Part-time is a compound word. Part-time is a hyphenated compound word. And teacher is a noun. As you know, teacher, noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing. So teacher is a noun. But when part-time comes before a noun, part-time is written before a noun, it has a hyphen. It comes as a hyphenated compound word. And that is first sentence. That is part-time. When I write part-time teacher, and the part-time is a compound word which precedes a noun, then I have to put the hyphen. And see the next sentence. A teacher that is part-time. And here I have not put the hyphen here because it comes after a noun. When the hyphenated compound word comes after a noun, it is not necessary to put hyphen. But when it precedes a noun, a hyphen is needed. So compound words, when it is preceding a noun, it comes as hyphenated compound words. And when it comes after a noun, this is the noun, when it comes after a noun, there is no hyphen. Okay, and such compound words are called modifying compound words. Modifying compound words, that is, it depends on the noun. Its position depends, the hyphen depends on the noun. If it is preceding, that is, it comes before a noun, it is hyphenated. If it comes after a noun, when part-time comes after, and this is the noun, When it comes after a noun, it is not hyphenated. So those compound words, those hyphenated compound words, which depends on the position of the noun in a sentence, is called modifying compounds. Okay. So just remember this. When a hyphenated compound word comes before a noun, it is hyphenated. When it comes after a noun, it is not hyphenated. Is it clear? So just study some of the words which are hyphenated. Is it clear to you? Hello. So there were three types of compound words. What were the three types of compound words? What were the three types of compound words? Type in your chat box. What were the three types of compound words? Okay, closed compound word. Siddharth had said closed compound word. Then next one is, okay, open compound word and closed compound word, open compound word, and one more, the last one, hyphenated compound word. Ashwin, okay. Hyphenated compound word. Very good. So these are the three kinds of compound words. Open compound words have space in between. Example, together. Okay. Closed compound words do not have space in between. Example, ice cream. Just study a few examples. Then, hyphenated compound words, they have hyphen in between words. And the example, mother-in-law, father-in-law, etc. Is it clear? And these compound words, the small words, they have different meanings. But when they combine together to form a single word, they give an entirely different meaning than its original meaning. Okay. Is it clear to you? Hello. Okay. So this next section, synonyms, I had told earlier in the second class, I think I had covered synonyms about thesaurus. I've showed you how to include a thesaurus in a Word document. I had demonstrated this part, isn't it? Do you remember how to choose thesaurus from a Word document? And I had also given you synonyms with A, isn't it? I think you had written the 12 synonyms. You had written down the 12 synonyms, isn't it? Do you remember? Hello, okay. I had showed you how to include a thesaurus in your Word document, the steps to include the thesaurus, and the section was covered earlier in the second class. Anyway, I have given it in the notes also. It is there in LingWays. And here, the synonyms I had included only with letters A. And I had written in this note that synonyms for letter B to Z, I had uploaded in LingWays. The other synonyms are also uploaded in LingWays. So you can just go to LingWays and you can see there will be a file called misspelled words. There is a file for misspelled words. Then synonyms notes are uploaded. The words from B to Z synonyms are also uploaded. And with this course note, which I am displaying here, it is also uploaded. Okay, so you can go to that, log into LingWays and write down the lecture notes, the main points, not everything, but the main points has to be written down neatly. If you are writing the whole thing, then you will study. So just go through the notes, learn the notes and write down the lecture notes. Okay, if you are not able to write it down now, just write it down later. Is it clear? Just write a few examples. Don't write all the examples. Just write one or two examples. Okay. If any doubt, you can just ask me. Okay, later. So in the next, we'll continue with the next section in the next class. That is, next we have to go to another section. That is paraphrasing. Tomorrow we'll take paraphrasing. Okay. Now see your attendance. See your attendance.
One.
Two.
two, two,
Okay. Next.
three,
Next. You can continue the numbers, okay? Four absent.
four present,
Okay. Four,
five,
then five.
six,
seven,
eight,
Nine.
ten,
11.
twelve,
13.
14.
15.
16.
17.
18.
19. 20.
21.
22.
23.
24.
25. Number 25. Absent. 26. Number 26.
25. 25.
Okay. 26. 26 absent.
27.
Okay.
28. 28.
Okay.
29.
30.
Okay.
31. 31.
Okay.
32.
Okay.
33.
Okay.
34.
Okay.
35.
Okay.
36.
Okay.
37.
Okay.
38.
Okay.
39.
Okay.
40.
Okay.
41.
Okay.
42.
Okay.
43.
Okay.
44.
Okay.
45.
Okay.
46.
Okay.
47.
Okay.
48.
Okay.
49.
Okay.
50.
50.
50.
Number 50.
Present, ma'am.
50 absent.
Present, ma'am.
Okay.
51.
Present. Okay. 52.
52. 53.
Okay.
54.
Okay.
55.
Okay.
56.
Okay.
57.
Okay.
58.
Okay.
59.
Okay.
60.
Okay.
61.
Okay.
62.
Okay.
63.
Okay. So this number 26 is absent, right? Number 26. Shireen, Misbah Shireen. Number 26 absent, okay. Thank you, thank you.